Hey, thanks for checking out this tutorial video on the logo creator by Laughingbird Software. So there's a great TV show I watch called The Walking Dead. It's on the AMC network here in the United States.
People are gonna start panicking. We can't give up.
Like I said, it's all about slim chances now. And a slim chance is better than none.
The Walking Dead. New episodes Sunday nights at 9. Only on AMC.
It's a really suspenseful TV show about the zombie apocalypse. So after The Walking Dead show, there's a follow-up show called The Talking Dead. They talk about what happened during the show. It's really fun to watch. And during the commercial breaks, The Talking Dead always show their logo. And after seeing this logo a bunch of times, I thought, hey, I wonder if the logo creator could create this. So that's what I'm going to do in this tutorial. I'm going to show you how to take this logo and replicate it using the logo creator. Here we go. All right, here we are in a new document in the logo creator. I simply went under the file menu and hit new, and it created a blank document. I have the logo here I can look at, so let's get started. Window a little bigger. The first thing we have to do is type in the text. So we type in talking. Add to canvas. And we'll make it bigger by scaling, format, scaling text, talking. And we have to find the correct font. So the logo creator contains a bunch of built-in fonts, and you can also use your own system fonts, whatever you have on. Computer. But for now, let's look into the system fonts and find a good close font. No, that's too big. There you go. That's pretty close. Good enough. We don't want to replicate the logo exactly because we don't want to get sued by them, of course. So let's do that. And now you'll notice in the logo that it has a kind of a 3D effect. So two things we have to do is create the glossy front and the 3D. So let's make the glossy front first. There's a cool trick in the logo creator that lets you import textures. So first we need to find a glossy texture. So we can go into the logo creator and look for backgrounds and textures. And here's a couple of them. Here's a good one. Here's a nice blue one. So watch this cool trick. So we're gonna drag it to the canvas. And now this is blue, so we can colorize this a little bit. Let's make this big. I'm gonna colorize it a little bit to be a little bit more gray, like the Talking Dead image here. Image color, colorize it. And we can make it a little bit gray, as long as we see this glossy line in here. Now watch this. We're going to export as a JPEG, and we'll put it into a folder. We're going to call this glossy image, whatever you want to call it. Save it. And now we can simply delete it out of the logo creator and click on the text again. Click on the word talking. And now we're going to hit the color button. We're going to import that image that we just got rid of, that we just exported. Click on Browse. Find it in your folder, Glossy Image. And it's in there, but now we have to position it so we can see that line in there. There we go, right about like that. It's a little hard to see. We didn't do it too good, so let's just try that again. Bring this in. Let's make it more prominent. And there, we're just going to export it just like that. So let's export this again. We'll call this glossy image 2. Click it and delete it off the canvas. And we're going to click on the text again. And we're going to browse for that same image. There we go. It's blue, but you know, you get the idea. Down just a little bit. There we go. let's bring in a background too first. The logo creator has backgrounds in it, like this one. You can bring it in, make it bigger. But this is a paisley pattern. We don't want a paisley pattern. Here's kind of a grungy look to it. That's more of a blue jeans type of thing. Is that in the back? Nope. Okay, so the logo creator doesn't really have what we want. There's something kind of close. So we're going to go out on the web and look for a good background. So let's click on our browser, and we're going to type in free web backgrounds. And we go to the images tab. And now we're going to find some cool backgrounds to use. So here is, well, that's kind of a cool one. It's grungy. We might want to use that for something. So if we keep looking for other backgrounds, they have some nice ones in here. Like, oh, this is kind of close, not quite. Let's keep looking, looking, looking. Ah, here we go, look at that. Okay, getting closer. If we click on it, let's see what that looks like. Okay, it looks like it brought me to a web page. Oh, here's the background here. So here's what I like to do. Right click over the background. On my Mac I can do this. I think on Windows you can do this too. We're going to open the image in a new window. There we go. That's pretty close. And now we can just click and drag it into a folder on our desktop. And then go back to the logo creator and using the file import, we can find the image. Here we go. It's a web background texture. Here we go. Let's try that. Is that it? Yep, there it is. All right. Almost perfect. So let's send this to the back. There we go. Okay. So let's colorize it a little bit to make it more of the color of the Talking Dead image here. Click on Image Color, Colorize, and now we're going to colorize it kind of a greenish blue color here. The opacity, the higher the opacity, it colorizes the image. And if you lower the opacity, you'll see you get kind of a fine line here between the two. There's the full image, there's the full color, and in between, you can do both. All right, now that we have the background and now we have the word talking, we can make our 3D effect. So what I like to do is duplicate and take the image that's behind in the back and colorize this white. Color, solid, white. Because you'll notice there's a white background. And actually, it's a slight gradient. So maybe let's just try that to see what it looks like. Gradient from gray to white. And we'll make it. Twist the gradient so the gray's on the top. There we go. And there's that. And now we'll take the upper text layer on top and drag it just enough so it looks a little 3D-ish. Position that. There we go. How's that? 3D looking? And now we're going to type in the word dead. Let's type in dead. We're going to find a similar font. White so we can see it, and we're going to make it bigger. That's good, but it's also capitals. So if it's in capitals, we want to type in edit and type it in capitals instead. How's that? There we go. Close enough, huh? Now we have to find a grunge look for the word dead here. So let's go back to the web, type in something like white grunge background. Let's try that. White grunge background. There we go. Now, oh, look at that. Perfect. Oh, and it's a little bit too dark, but you get the idea. So there's something. There's a good one. There's a good one. Here, that's pretty close. There we go. Click on that one. I don't know how big this is going to be. Okay, some of these you're gonna have to buy. I type in free web backgrounds. Make sure you look at the copyright information, you know, before you use anything in the logo creator. You don't want to get copyright infringement. To create a pattern for letters, you're not going to get too yelled at, but you just be careful what you're looking at here. So here's a free one that's kind of grungy. Let's try that one. Okay, so I've saved it to the folder here. I've saved it in this folder. It's right there. Okay, so we're going to go back to the logo creator, and we're going to choose the color button again for the word dead, color, image. I'm going to find that grunge image, which is this one here. All right, pretty close. It's a little bit more fuzzy than I wanted, but not bad, not bad. There we go, how's that? Okay, this now has a reflection and a slight 3D effect in the background. So let's not worry about the 3D effect, but let's try and create the reflection here. So for the reflection, I'm going to click on the text, and I'm going to duplicate the text under the Modify menu. Duplicate selected element. Duplicate it. We're going to bring it down beneath. And we are going to, first we're going to colorize it. Now you notice there's black on the bottom, so we're going to do a little trick that I like to do with the logo creator. We're going to colorize this in a gradient so that the bottom is black to match the back black background, and the top is more of the white in the logo. So we'll make that like a gray, and we'll stretch the gradient out. And we're going to have to flip the gradient now so that the black is on the bottom. Stretch it out even more. Here we go, like that. And then we're going to fade the opacity down, down, down. And then we're going to flip the text so it's like a mirror image. Format and flip horizontal. And then flip vertical. Well, let's not flip horizontal then. There we go. And we're going to bring this down. Getting close. We need to fade the opacity a little bit more. It's too bright still. So we're gonna say format. Nope, sorry, we're gonna have to click on color and bring the opacity down. There we go. Now we're talking. Alright. There's the reflection, and talking is up here. We got the background image, and we need to put a shadow. There's a little shadow here, so it looks like it's sitting on a floor. So in the logo creator, we can go and find shadows and gradients. And we can find a bunch of little shadows here. Let's do this one. We bring it down, and we're going to increase it so it's bigger. Drop it behind the text a little bit. So we're going to send further back, and we're going to duplicate to make a longer shadow. So you can kind of, you get the idea. You can kind of play with this whole thing. That back there. There we go. All right. So let's bring the text here way to the front so everything is sitting behind it. You can't really see the shadow, but it's subtle and it's there. So it looks kind of like it's sitting on the floor. And we might want to put just a tiny 3D effect to this. So let's try this. Let's duplicate the word dead. And we're going to bring the opacity of the background, of the back text down just a little bit to make it just a little bit darker. Down, a little bit darker. And then we'll bring this up just so it's just a tad 3D-ish. There, how's that? And finally, we're going to go out on the web and we're going to find, because we want to give AMC credit for this because it is just a terrific show, we're going to go find the AMC logo. Go out on the web. All right, here's a good one for us. So we'll just use this logo for now, and we'll drag this into a folder, and we'll go back to the logo creator, and now we're going to bring in the logo. So we'll go to File, Import, find our AMC logo. There it is. We're going to make it smaller. There we go. Not bad. There is our Talking Dead logo. Pretty cool. Now go out and make one yourself, and watch for more tutorials on the logo creator by Laughingbird Software.